Hey! Welcome to 3Dnatives Lab. I'm Elliot, and today we're testing the RAYSHAPE Edge E1. The Edge E1 is RAYSHAPE's first MSLA 3D printer designed specifically for the dental sector. Since its creation in 2019, the Chinese company has expanded to enter the European and North American markets as it seeks to become an additive manufacturing global player for dental, manufacturing, engineering, education, cultural and creative industries. With this newest addition to its product lineup, RAYSHAPE now explores the capabilities of the MSLA or LCD process, which has evolved significantly in recent years, mainly thanks to higher pixel density LCDs. This technology now shares most of the advantages and technical capacities of DLP, RAYSHAPE's preferred technology up to this point, while coming in at a lower price point. The whole product range of RAYSHAPE is split in two categories, dental and industrial. The dental line is made up of two desktop resin 3D printers. The Shape 1 Plus Dental is a DLP 3D printer and the Edge E1 MSLA. Whilst the industrial one includes four resin DLP 3D printers, the two Shape 1 Plus printers are budget entry points in the product range, whereas the P200 and P400 offer improved dimensional accuracy. Apart from the P400, all the printers are desktop machines. The dental ecosystem offered by RAYSHAPE includes desktop 3D printer itself, the wash and cure post-processing machines, as well as a range of dental resins, all of which we'll delve into later in this video. After testing this resin dental desktop 3D printing solution extensively over the past few weeks, we're ready to share our service. Let's now take a closer look at the machine specifications, starting with the hardware. The moment you unbox the Edge E1, you'll notice its robust and well-built construction. Its sturdy sheet metal frame ensures durability and the linear rails enable smooth and precise movements of the build platform. The printer features a 7-inch color touchscreen, providing a user-friendly interface. While the Edge E1 is not the most compact resin 3D printer on the market, it boasts a clean and professional look by concealing most of its mechanical parts. The printer measures 390 by 420 by 535 mm, offering a decent build volume of 192 by 120 by 190 mm, suitable for dental application. The integrated interchangeable charcoal activated filter is a notable feature that reduces odors and potential harmful emissions like VOCs during the printing process. This is particularly crucial in a medical environment where air quality is a concern. Let's now shift our focus towards the software and ecosystem that accompanies the Edge E1. RAYSHAPE provides its own slicing software called Shapeware. While the slicer works fine, it's important to note that it was initially developed in Chinese and later translated into English, resulting in a few mistranslations that can slightly detract from the user experience. However, the software is still usable and provides essential as well as more advanced functions for preparing models for printing. The slicer allows the user to orient, cut, hollow and support the prints. It also has an inbuilt array function, making batch printing easier. Shapeware comes with pre-configured profiles for each resin type sold by RAYSHAPE and allows for the creation and import of custom profiles. Being an open materials 3D printer, it allows users to print with any compatible resin. That being said, during our testing, we encountered a minor issue with resin profiles. Since we received all the resin samples, we had to use custom profiles sent by RAYSHAPE to achieve optimal printing results. Importing profiles into the slicer is straightforward, but end users receiving new resins won't need to go through this process. Once the profiles were imported, they were very easy to use and allowed for a streamlined printing experience. One limitation of the slicing software is its lack of support for the 3MF file format, which is increasingly used in the 3D printing industry. Therefore, users will need to make sure their files are saved or converted to STL or other supported formats before importing them into the slicer. On the positive side, the Shapeware slicer offers wireless print job sending to the Edge E1, enabling the transmission of print jobs wirelessly over the local network, enhancing convenience and flexibility. Now, let's move on to the prints themselves. One thing we did notice immediately when unboxing and using the Edge E1 3D printer is that the resin vat does not fill up or top itself up automatically. This means it has to be filled up manually and users have to ensure the resin level is sufficient before each print. When it comes to print quality, the parts printed on the Edge E1 are well detailed and accurately represent the 3D models. The individual voxels and layers are barely visible to the naked eye, showcasing the printer's capability to produce high resolution prints. To test the batch printing functionality of the Edge E1, we printed 40 pens along with the Joe model. If we wanted to max out the print volume of the printer with our pen model, we would be able to print up to 104 pens at once in under 8 hours. We could also print 12 dentures in under 5.5 hours. During our testing, we were able to validate tolerances up to 3 microns, and the manufacturer claims an average dimensional deviation of 0.05 mm or 50 microns. Now, let's move on to the post-processing part of the ecosystem. RAYSHAPE offers a washing station known as Shape Wash, which is an ultrasonic cleaning machine originally manufactured by Skyman and rebranded by RAYSHAPE. While the machine works well and features time and heating controls, it's worth mentioning that the heating function should not be used with solvents, especially alcohol, due to the flammable and explosive nature of the solvent. It's a small oversight that indicates the machine was not developed specifically by RAYSHAPE, but rather rebranded. The curing station, called Shape Cure, is easy to operate and comes with pre-configured profiles for every resin type sold by RAYSHAPE. This simplifies the post-processing workflow, ensuring that prints are properly cured for optimal strength and stability. Whilst the Shape Cure isn't connected to the internet, we believe it could be updated by the user thanks to the integrated USB-A port hidden inside the machine, thus ensuring the addition of future resin profiles. It is worth noting that the Shape Wash is relatively small, which can make some prints hard to post-process. If you plan on printing larger parts, RAYSHAPE also offers a bigger ultrasonic cleaning station. The manufacturer also sells a smaller curing station, the Shape Cure Mini. In conclusion, the RAYSHAPE Edge E1 provides a solid dental 3D printing solution with its robust hardware, accurate print quality and user-friendly ecosystem. The printer's well-built frame and linear rails ensure stability and precise movements, resulting in accurate and detailed prints. While the software could benefit from improvements, such as better translations and support for the 3MF5 format, it still offers all the necessary functions for preparing models for printing. Some more advanced options like array positioning can also prove particularly useful for batch dental 3D printing. The accompanying curing and washing stations, Shape Cure and Shape Wash respectively, add convenience and efficiency to the post-processing workflow. Although the heating function of the washing station should not be used with solvents, it still provides effective cleaning with the ultrasonic technology. Coming in at $3,500 for the printer alone, RAYSHAPE's commitment to the dental industry is evident in the Edge E1 and its ecosystem. As the company continues to expand its presence in global markets, we anticipate further advancements and enhancements to their offerings. As per usual, we rated the RAYSHAPE Edge E1 and gave it a final score of 9 out of 10. To discover how we got to this score, check out our written review. Thank you for joining us in this review of the RAYSHAPE Edge E1. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below in the comment section. Check out our other videos as well as the dedicated 3Dnatives Lab playlist for more 3D printing content. See you in the next video.